In a small network, a relatively small system where you have the person that built the system is the person that is still running the system. So often you'll have this in the types of environments that you were describing before in the MOD, where somebody built something and they've been babysitting it, in essence, ever since. They know everything there is to know about all the configuration, the databases, the environment variables. They know the code inside and out. This is the one case where the administrator truly knows everything that there is to know about the system until the agile truck factor gets involved. I never really liked the agile truck factor. I prefer the why couldn't they get promoted, move to another company? They don't have to get run over by a truck for us to lose that godlike administrator capability. Thing is that once they move on, for whatever reason, their replacement won't know what to do. So we need to start from the assumption that the people who are administering and monitoring our systems don't really know everything that there is to know about them. Now, coming back to the developer side of things, because most of us are on the developer side of the equation, thing is we don't often know everything there is to know about the system. Let me ask you this. Who knows what every bit of configuration in their system does? Okay, got one hand going up. Two out of 34. All right. How many of you think you know what all of the configuration does? The problem with configuration is it starts very innocuously. It's the, well, we need connection strings and we need all sorts of physical things. And then along the way, two developers are having a conversation of, should we make it do X or Y? And then they kind of go back and forth and back and forth, and nobody's really able to convince the other one. The answer is make it configurable, right? Then we can decide effectively not to decide right now when the system goes live. We can flip a switch and make it go this way or that way. And the more configuration options that we create, the less likely that anybody's going to know what a given set of specific knobs and dials is going to end up doing. And that results in sort of this voodoo type of experience of, well, it worked yesterday. It doesn't work today, and we're kind of doing a diff, and all the config looks the same. Did you look at the database? That's part of the problem with configuration, is that half of it ends up in a database somewhere, right? And then another half is in environment variables or config files or various other types of locations. And it's really hard to understand what exactly a given change is going to do. So this relates to the whole multiple administrators. The more knobs and dials that you have, the more likely there are going to be more people tweaking them. If you're using a queuing system, that's yet another dial that somebody might change, that they install some patch to the queuing system that makes it work differently than how it did before. The more moving parts that you've got, and that was the question that was raised before, the more moving parts that you've got, the more likely that they're going to get out of sync with each other, and then something's not going to work. So it's important to understand the bigger and the more complex the distributed system is, the less likely that there's going to be any one person that understands how everything works. So you do invest in some kind of configuration management. Take the time to slow down, document things, create well-known, stable run points, back up the system. These are things that your administrators should know how to do. The reality is many of them don't. And then what happens? They call us in, right? They say, something doesn't work. You go figure it out, right? You wrote the system. You should be able to figure it out. And then you're going, you know, line by line debugging things, and you're not really sure why it's not working either. So understand that this kind of stuff is just going to get worse.
Hi, I'm Udi Dahan. I hope you're enjoying these clips on the fallacies of distributed computing. Click on the left to watch the next video, or on the right to go to the fallacies playlist, or in the middle to subscribe to our channel. For more information, including the full videos from my course, check out the links below the video. Thanks, and see you next time.